Namaste. Ayurveda is a system of medicine and lifestyle developed in ancient India. Acharya Charaka, who is known as one of the principal contributors of Ayurveda, said that there is no plants which has no relevance on the earth. Each and every plant has to do something with the nature. I would like to say a few words about a herbal plant which has very important role in our day-to-day life and in Ayurveda. It is very common in India and in Southeast Asia. It is nothing but Tulsi or Tulasi or the holy basil with the botanical name Osimum Sanctum. In Sanskrit, the word Tulasi means incomparable. The meaning itself describes the importance of the plant. It is known as the queen of herb. Tulasi is a subshrub about 30 cm to 1 meter tall with multiple branches and tiny hairy stem. There are mainly three types of Tulasi found in India, which are Ram Tulasi with bright green leaves, Krishna Tulasi with purple green leaves, and the wild Vana Tulasi. People are using Tulasi to prepare different types of home remedies for various diseases like fever, cough, cold, etc. And in Ayurveda, Tulasi is using to prepare Tulasi means Tulasi leaves, Tulasi flowers, and the entire Tulasi is used to prepare different types of medicines called Arishtam, Kashaya, oil, etc. Ayurveda expert says integrating Tulasi in your diet may not only help you to look good but can also boost your physical and mental health. Tulasi is known to combat stress. It is an adaptogen, which means anti-stress agent, known to promote mental wellness. It can regulate cortisol level and reduce anxiety and emotional stress. The herb can help to relieve from congestion in the lungs, and it alleviates symptoms of fever, cough, cold, headache, jaundice, malaria, etc. It has antiviral, antibacterial, antifungal properties, which is an excellent choice when it refers to treat infections. It contains detoxifying properties and antioxidant which rejuvenate the skin. The Tulasi can reduce, or Tulasi leaves, its extract can reduce the toxins responsible for various skin diseases. It can prevent people from premature aging. People often used to give Tulasi leaves extract to the infants to boost their immunity and to avoid cough and stomach abnormalities. The oil preparing with Tulasi leaves can cure the ear pain. Crushed dry leaves of Tulasi can use as Nasiga Churnam, which can cure cold. The Tulasi leaves, or having Tulasi leaves every day, can prevent people from oral diseases, and it can provide preventive properties to the patients having gum diseases. Thus, Tulasi is an entire package or complete package when it refers to Ayurveda. The medicine derived from Tulasi is often used to treat various diseases related with kidney, stomach, heart, lungs, and etc. Knowing the importance of Tulasi, people started to cultivate Tulasi in industrial basis. For example, in Thoothukudi, which is in Tamil Nadu, with the help of National Mission for Medicinal Plants, farmers started to cultivate Tulasi in large scale. Even in foreign nations, people started to care and cultivate Tulasi in their courtyard and in gardens. I am very happy to say that we can find a single variety of Tulasi in Djibouti as well. It is a type of Vana Tulasi, and it's locally known as Raihan. I think the name is Arabic. According to Hindu mythology, Tulasi is the known as the avatar of Lakshmi Devi, the wife of God Mahavishnu, and people often worship Tulasi. What I have learned is worship Tulasi, or worship anything in the nature, is the way of reserving natural elements for the coming generations. On this auspicious occasion, I would like to say thanks to Indian Embassy Djibouti for promoting Ayurveda in a country like Djibouti. And also I have a request to Indian Embassy, if the embassy can take initiative to make a contract between government of India and the government of Djibouti to promote Ayurveda, which can help the Indian community in Djibouti and the other expatriates coming from various countries and the local Djiboutian as well. I would like to say thanks to Indian Embassy Djibouti to give a chance to talk something about Ayurveda, and I would like to say thanks to government of India. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.